Hi everyone, my name is Patrick and I'm a product manager on the Edge DevTools team. Welcome to this video. Today I'm going to show you a new feature that we've added to Edge DevTools that lets you use Copilot in Edge to debug your web pages. If you're not familiar with Copilot in Edge, it's a very powerful AI assistant that's built right into Edge. You can use it to search the web, to answer questions about the pages that you're currently viewing, create content, and many more things. You can always access Copilot in Edge by clicking the Copilot button in the top right corner of Edge. And now you can use Copilot in Edge to debug your web pages as well. That's right, we've actually integrated Edge DevTools with Copilot. And now with this, you can explain errors and warnings that you see in the console tool of DevTools, and you can get ideas for how to fix those errors. Let me show you how this works. So here I am in Microsoft Edge. I am working on this web application that I developed some time ago, which is a music player. When I click on the play icon at the bottom of the list here to play this last track, nothing happens. So if I open Edge DevTools now and I see the console tool at the bottom here, I notice that there's an error that's displayed here. This error doesn't really make a lot of sense to me. I've not really worked with media sessions before, which is one of the terms that's mentioned here. So I don't really understand what that error means, and I need help to go and do something about it. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna click on the Copilot icon that's right next to the error in the console tool. As soon as I click this icon, you'll notice that the Edge sidebar opens up with Copilot in it, and you conversation started, and I can see that my error message is pasted in the sidebar here with a message from me on my behalf asking Copilot to please explain the error that's displayed in Edge DevTools. And I can see that Copilot is providing an explanation for the error in simpler terms so that I can understand what's going on. It's given me links for other websites that I may want to visit later to learn even more about that particular error. And it's trying to also give me a possible solution at the end. So let me pause here and take a closer look at the explanation for my error. So this is due to the media session API, and in particular to the set position state method. And if I look at the type error explanation further down, I can see that it may be due to the fact that either the duration is missing or negative or non-finite, or the position is negative or greater than duration, or the playback rate is zero. So what I can do now is I can visit those links that Copilot has given me to find out even more about the media session API and the set position state method, and I can learn more and really understand where the error is coming from. And I can also jump right into debugging as well, because I know that the problem comes from one of those parameters that I'm passing, and I even have a possible solution here. And if I go back to the console tool, next to the error message, there's always this link that links to where the error came from. So let me click on that to go and investigate the code directly. So I'm taken to the sources tool, and I see directly the line of code that's problematic here. I can decide to add a breakpoint and then hit the play button again, and I should pause here, and I can now use the sources tool to just see what the values of these parameters are. So duration here in particular is non-finite, it's infinity, which is probably what the problem is here. But that's not all. If I want to go further, or if I need more information, I can continue the conversation with Copilot. The initial question and answer happened in this Copilot sidebar. And within this sidebar, the context is already set. So I can just keep on asking more questions to Copilot, and it will continue answering me with the right context in mind. With all of this, I now know how to fix my error, and I can continue working on my web page. We think this feature will be very useful for developers, and we hope you'll enjoy using it. But there's one more thing too. We also integrated the sources tool with Copilot in Edge. The sources tool is where you can see and debug all of your source code, right? But now you can also ask Copilot to explain code to you that's displayed in the sources tool. Let's say I'm still not quite sure how to fix the code because I don't really understand that piece of code. I can use Copilot to explain it to me. All I have to do is to select the code that I'm interested in, right-click, and choose Explain with Copilot. This will use the Copilot in Edge sidebar again, send the selected code to it, and then Copilot will try to explain the code to me in plain English and give me some examples or links to help me understand it better. So that's how you can use Copilot in Edge to explain warnings, errors, and source code from DevTools. If you're interested in this feature, you can try it out today. It's already in Microsoft Edge available for you to try. If you are not seeing the icon to explain errors in the console tool, you may have to enable it first. And to do this, you can learn more at aka.ms/devtools-copilot-docs. Now, if you have any feedback or questions or thoughts about this feature, you can reach out to us at aka.ms/devtools-copilot-feedback. And with that, thanks a lot for watching and happy debugging.